Alright, we are back to our project. So the goal today is getting the valve covers pulled off so we can see the valves. That way I can get my cam bridge back here. Once I get the cam bridge back there, I'll break loose the phasers. And then I'll get my timing tool back in there. I'm going to replace the bolts because they're torque to yields. I got two new bolts. I did get officially from the dealership the torque spec, which is what I used. It was 18 foot-pounds plus 75 degrees. And I'm going to go a little tighter. I talked to a guy that worked there. He said he wouldn't be afraid to go 18 foot-pound plus 90 since that slipped. I'm curious if it's loose or how loose it is. Yeah. So anyways, that's our goal today. Get this tore back off, time it. So it fits on that side, doesn't fit over here, and actually it looks like the exhaust is slightly off too, not as much as my intake is. Break my tensioner loose, I gotta get these caps off. Just gonna get all that out of the way. I'll take the bolts out, and then we'll line up our cams, or our phasers, keep saying cams, line up our phasers with our tool here. We'll get those lined back up. So here we go. Got both the phasers in, tools in. Okay, cam bridge is nice and happy. So now, this is 18 foot-pound plus 75, but since I had an issue, I'm gonna go 18 foot-pound plus 90, because I'm scared. So I'm not going to go back over the entire top end timing process. If you want to see some details, go back to some of my original videos. I have the entire rebuild and engine replacement cataloged multi-port series. So anyways, check that up here in the corner if you want to go back and check that out. But anyways, the point of this is to show that I had to retime it. I didn't damage anything. It just slipped out of time and gave me some misfire codes. But we're going to get this put back together and then we're going to go for a test drive. Bridge is still in. Okay, nailed that one. Hey, there we go. Okay. We are finally fixed for once. Let's go take a final drive here. Got the AC charged. I got my first oil change complete. Since the engine's been done, got about 400 miles on it before I changed it. Let's get a quick little run around. Got the AC nice and cold. She seems to be driving pretty good. Now, give you a little backstory. I ended up retiming this three times due to misfires. And I was under the impression that I had mistimed this somehow. Now, as a refresher, I had about 9 months of dealing with Ford and trying to get parts at a reasonable price. I was trying to get him to warranty this because this should have been warrantied, but it was not. So I spent about 9 months fighting it, ended up doing it myself. And in that 9 months of time, the octane of the fuel had went down quite a bit. I am almost certain that my misfires were pretty much exclusively due to bad fuel. So after I had thought of that, put a new tank of fuel in it and ran around a bunch, I got misfires two more times, and then it stopped altogether. So, yeah, kind of a bonehead move on my part, but I was just trying to be safe. I wasn't trying to crash anything top end wise, but yeah, I've had a tank of fuel on this and now I'm in fresh oil change, and you know, we can give her a rip here. No check engine. Runs pretty good. I will call this a conclusion to my engine replacement on the 1.5 liter EcoBoost. And hopefully you guys don't ever have to deal with stuff like this. This is very unfortunate. The car was experiencing issues and was having coolant consumption and oil consumption issues on this engine at 96,000 miles. Took it to Ford. There was no engine codes, but it was slowly consuming it. I asked them to pull plugs, do an inspection on some parts. They didn't do that and charged me for 2 hours worth of labor. I returned back to them at 114,000 miles to let them know that I had the engine code they were asking for at that point, which was the misfire, and then I was having obviously major coolant consumption issues. And that's when the motor finally let go. But anyways, yeah, they told me to pound sand. I tried Ford Care, tried my local dealership, fought back and forth, called 700 people. I ended up doing the job myself, but I complained enough that they actually gave me a discount on parts. They sold me parts at cost to them, or their cost. So I was able to get this whole thing done after my core return for about $1,600 and a lot of heartache. So, yeah, like if you would have discounted all the time I spent taking this thing back apart 2-3 times, the way that I ended up doing the job took about, oh, I'd say right at 30 hours. I believe book time was 21. I was doing this odds and ends in between work and weekends and nights and stuff like that. So it took me a little while. Plus, I was just obviously being real careful. Hopefully this guide, it's not a super in-depth guide, but hopefully it shows you things that maybe some of the other videos don't. Hopefully this is fairly insightful. If it's not, I can give you guys more information. Just post down below what you want to see. But this is the conclusion to my 1.5 liter EcoBoost engine replacement. And we're back on the road again. Have a good one, guys. See you next time on Fixed-ish.